On Friday, May 31st, 2024, I pulled in to the Walgreens parking lot at East Gray Street in Bedford and caught local C89 heading east out of Rockport. I then leapfrogged the train to CP102 in Macedonia to watch it work the IDS warehouse. This move usually takes around an hour. Today I'm with my good friend Ray Meadows railfanning this portion of the Upper Cleveland Line. C89 begins its reverse move into the IDS spur to pick up the outbound cars and spot the inbounds. While this happens, eastbound 20X will pass by on Main 2 with my fifth consecutive catch of the Illinois Terminal Heritage Unit, this time as a trail fail.
Come over here. I don't bite.
I don't do.
I don't
know
about
that. C89 is a turn job that runs Monday through Friday out of Rockport Yard in Cleveland. It works various industries between Maple Heights and Macedonia, including the IDS warehouse and the Crown Industrial Spur in Twinsburg, which branches off the main here at CP102.
Not good enough. Is that what I think I see?
Vibration compensation on that. I can't lock
I
it.
I can't see.
It's an intermodal. That looks like a solo head, though.
No.
I know it ain't.
No, that's 1072.
Hello?
Yep.
Oh, yep, that is.
Uh-huh. Yeah!
Alright, shut up. I'm filming. Wait, I might be able to get a side shot. Don't move.
There's been an increasing amount of Amazon Prime containers on Norfolk Southern Premium trains. I'm pretty sure they're now domestic customers in this region.
1.6 track 1, no defects.
Switch five for the main, bring it back clear 50.
They gotta back up to the lights.
Little over an hour later, C89 is done at the warehouse and is now reversing behind the signals. A westbound must first get by him before he can get permission up the Crown secondary. Christian Clark and Winston Winkleman have since joined us.
My camera's probably gonna die if I leave it on all day.
Yeah, I wouldn't recommend it.
Oh, 65E.
Hello!
Excuse me, hello?
How about that?
Excuse me, I'm not set up for this.
Okay, track 2 hot, thanks. 102.
There he is. Or there she is, I should say.
Hello? Camera? Camera? Hello?
Hello, scanner? Hello? Come on. Here we go. Ouch.
Buffer.
Bro lost his buffer.
Hey, at least he still has his EOT.
They said, hey.
Mine should be up next.
I'm about to have no sunglasses on now.
Hey there.
102, permission up, over.
Can you hold this for a second?
Do that, permission up, say hello.
Alright, permission up, thanks. K9 out.
I'm right.
The Crown secondary is under the control of the Rockport Yardmaster. The 89 crew must first contact Rockport for permission up the secondary before receiving signal indication at 102. Me and Ray decide to give chase, getting a shot at the Highland Road overpass.
looks like a dash 2 coming around that corner.
Doesn't it?
The branch makes a big horseshoe and then comes back around to cross over Highland Road again at grade. There's a semi-truck situated on the other side of the crossing with a train horn, and he's about to have a horn battle with the C89. The 5805 and 5808 initially started their lives out as GP50 high hoods working on Southern Railway. They ended up on Norfolk Southern after the 1982 Southern and Norfolk and Western merger, being rebuilt into standard cab GP38-3s in the early 2000s. We knew that the C89 was destined to outlaw on the crown that day, so we left it there and moved back to 102 just in time for westbound 23G. It was now high noon, and me and Ray were hungry, so we said goodbye to Christian and broke off for lunch. I wanted Chick-fil-A, so that's where I went. Meanwhile, Ray went to Culver's with his grandmother. Once we were done eating, we both decided to go down to Alliance to intercept a 66X, which was receiving a fresh crew at Rock Hill Road. There was also an 11K on the other side of the junction at Railroad Street, also receiving a new crew. And if that wasn't enough, there's now a third train in the picture. NS-258 would have to slither between both trains, taking the diverging route at the junction. Eleven K promptly got moving after 258 cleared. Formerly an Allentown to Conway manifest, the 11K is now a bona fide PSR product, replacing the work of two different trains. It now comes out of Croxton, New Jersey, and runs all the way to Elkhart, Indiana. It replaces 19G, which ran from Croxton to Enola, and 13N, which ran Conway to Elkhart. And as you'd expect, it is a monster, usually running no shorter than 10,000 feet. I sprinted to the Amtrak platform after 11K called the clear at Alliance. It turns out that I actually quite like this shot. Historically speaking, 11K was always an Elkhart train before being abolished by PSR in 2019 and eventually being repositioned to terminate at Conway. Now in 2024, in an act of pure deja vu, the very thing that destroyed it 5 years ago has now brought it back. Welcome back, 11K, to the Cleveland Line. The 66X then blasted off from Rock Hill Road after 11K passed, with a KCS Gevo and a CP Gevo on the rear. This would go on to meet westbound 65K in Sebring.
Nice.
You have those crossings, you have the 67 marker, the middle there, you have Freshly Road.
Oh, we left your scanner on the bench, good. $65K.
I think so, yeah.
Play stupid.
On guard.
It is 65K. It's a BNSF one.
65K clear lines to us.
I didn't know your dog could dance. Watch us.
Yeah. Who knows?
Boys will be boys, girls will be girls.
Yep. Ain't that
quit eating the iron ingot pellets.
Tell me.
Oh no, she was just looking around. Probably should go back over to the bench with the stand.
Probably, yeah.
After 260, the 11Q showed up westbound with a mostly AC traction power move, with the exception of an SD40E trailing 6th. I believe it was getting heavy maintenance done in Bellevue.
To pick up that, those cars and finally pulled them at like 5:30.
Wow.
Hello?
I wouldn't make fun of somebody, but I am the one also taking a picture of the train.
Q, clear, line 2 west. 11Q.
11Q, hey, let's not bring a knuckle this time. 11Q, you gotta burn a knuckle. I gotta get a shot right here.
Just mount it right on.
Hot shoe plate. Okay, my camera's alive, but why is it not turning on, man?
Earlier this morning, there were two Sandusky-bound coal trains that went west on the Cleveland line, both symboled as 572, and they both had helper sets, one running as C80 and one as C76. Here comes both helper sets now, returning east to Conway light power. What usually are a pair of SD70 ACUs, today are two pairs of ES44s. Lately, Conway has been using whatever road power they can get their hands on while the ACUs are in the shops for their 92-day inspections.
The 80, he said.
The other.
Alright, let me look here.
Back to Conway, we are lead a road train. Maybe. Not exactly sure if you'll ever do that either, but sure.
We are currently in the help of it.
So have I.
I'll see you next time.
All right. That was good. That was terrible. All right.
After a long day of rail fanning, it was time to go home, so me and Ray parted ways. On my way home, he actually called me, saying that 269 was coming west. I sprinted ahead on Route 183 and quickly ducked in at Atwater for the shot. I've wanted to shoot a westbound at the S-curve for a long time, and the lighting was perfect to do that. I packed up my gear to actually go home this time. However, one more train would surprise me before I had the chance, that being eastbound 22X.